Hi students, today experiment is common base characteristics. So aim of this characteristics is to study input and output characteristics of transistor in common base characteristics. So required components are transistor BC547. So 54 series is NPN transistor. So I am using BC547. This is transistor. Here three terminals are having, it is having three terminals: emitter, base and collector. So this transistor is working or not, you have to check by using HFE mode in the transistor. Keep it in HFE mode, so you will get HFE value for this transistor. So emitter, base, collector. I am injecting here emitter, base, collector. So you are getting HFE value is 378. So this transistor is working, and this transistor value will be, HFE value will be 378. So emitter, base, collector. So emitter, base, collector. Okay. And we require two resistors for input side and output side. For input and output, one resistor is for current limiting purpose. Okay. And DRPS, voltmeter, ammeter, and breadboard and connecting wires. Okay. This is the circuit diagram for common base characteristics. The base is common to both input and output, that's why it is called as common base circuit. Here we are using two supplies, means in the DRPS we are using two channels. So this is one channel is used for input and one channel is used for output. Okay, and input is connected to resistor, and resistor is connected to emitter terminal, and base is connected directly connected to the ground, and collector is connected directly connected to resistor, and resistor is connected to VCC supply, second channel. Okay, now go to the connection. So this is emitter, base, collector. Transistor is emitter, base, collector. From this emitter, collector, transistor, you have to connect direct. Base is common to connected to ground. So if middle one, the terminal is base, so I am connecting base to ground. So I am assuming this total first, this node is assuming grounded, so connect here ground. Okay, next, where I am first input characteristics. I am connecting input characteristics circuit diagram. So from collector to here, collector to resistor, collector to resistor, and resistor to positive supply as the regulated power supply channel. Positive of the positive connected to positive here, and negative is connected to the grounded. And here for input side, supply negative is connected to some other node. Here I am connecting here, and positive is connected to grounded, and negative to resistor one terminal. Resistor of the one terminal, and second terminal is connected to some other node, and so second terminal is resistor to ammeter negative terminal. I am assuming this multimeter is using for ammeter, and this is for negative terminal is connected to resistor second terminal, and positive is connected to emitter terminal. Okay, next voltmeter for measuring the VBE. So negative is connected to emitter terminal, and positive is connected to grounded. Okay. For output side, you have one more voltmeter will be there for constant purpose VCB. So I am using this voltmeter here, and positive is connected to the collector terminal. Positive is connected to the collector terminal, and negative is connected to the grounded. So this is total circuit connection for input characteristics. Okay, for input characteristics, procedure will be connect the circuit as per the circuit diagram. Keep output voltages constant by varying the input voltage supply VEE. By varying this one, you have to measure the VBE and base to emitter voltage and I current, input current, that is IE current, okay, by gradually increasing for VEE. So now let's do the practical. Now these are VBE purpose and IE is VCB. Okay, now start the experiment. So first, now first VCB equal to 0, tabular column will be here for input characters. VCB equal to 0 and VWE, where is the VWE? Measuring the values of VBE and IE. Okay, next output is 0, VCB 0 means total 0 it is. Next increase, where is the values? VWE, VWE value is this one. So where is, like stepwise is 0.1 volts. For 0.1 volts you are getting 73 millivolts. For 0, for 0.1 volts, 0.72 means 0.072 volts. 72 millivolts means 0.072 millivolts, current will be 0. For 0.2 volts, 192 millivolts means 0.2 volts. Approximately this 0.2 volts, current will be 0. For 0.3 volts, 285 millivolts means approximately this 0.3 volts, current will be 0. For 0.4, you are getting 0.384 means approximately 0.4 volts, current is 0. For 0.5, you are getting 0.5 volts VBE, current will be 0.01 milliamps, 0.01 milliamps. For 0.6, current will be 0.54, voltage will be 0.548 and current is 0.1 milliamps. For 0.7, VBE is 0.559. Current is 0.15 milliamps. For 0.8, 0.572 and current is 0.24. For 0.9, voltage will be 0.580, current is 0.33 milliamps. For 1, 0.585, current is 0.40. Next we have to increase step wise is 1 volts, 2 volts like this. So for 2 volts, VWE, we are getting VB is 0.692 volts, current is 1.34. Next to 3 volts, 3 volts, voltage will be 0.729, current is 2.30. For 4 volts, 4 volts, voltage will be 0.750, current is 3.35 milliamps. For 5 volts, voltage is 0.765, current is 4.37. For 6, 0.776 and current is 5.36. For 7 volts, 7 volts, you are getting 0.785 volts VBE and current is IE is 6.37, or like 8 volts. For 8 volts, 0.793 volts, and current is 7.43 milliamps. So repeat the same this one to VCB equal to 2 volts. First, we have to minimize the input voltage total, and next we have to constant the output voltage VCB voltage, that is output side, by increasing, by varying the output channel VCB to 2 volts. VCB equal to 2 volts constant voltage. So I am constanting VCB equal to 2 volts. Here this is VCB equal to 2 volts. Same procedure here too. For increasing the, by varying the VWE voltage. So same, we have to measure the values of VB and IE. Next, again 0.1. For 0.1 volts, we are getting 100 millivolts. 100 millivolts means 0.1 volts. And current is 0 milliamps. For 0.2, we are getting 198 millivolts means 0.2 volts, and current is 0. For 0.3, 300 millivolts means 0.3 volts, and current is 0. For 0.4, 0.4 you are getting 0.4 volts, and current is 0.001 milliamps. For 0.5, you are getting VB is 0.49 and current is 0.014. For 0.6, 0.530 and current is 0.051. For 0.7, you are getting VB is 0.558 and current is 0.146. For 0.8, you are getting VB is 0.57 and current is 0.234. For 0.9, 0.575, current is 0.289. For 1 volt, you are getting 0.582 and current is 0.370. Now I am increasing for 2 volts, 3 volts, like that, up to 1.1. Next, you got increase like step wise is 1, 2, 3. So 2 volts, you are getting 0.60 and current is 1.30. For 3 volts, 0.635 and current is 2.54. For 4 volts, you are getting VB is 0.6957 and 3.40 milliamps for current. For 5 volts, voltage will be 0.732, current is 4.39. For 6 volts, 6 volt supply voltage, will be VB is 0.75 and current is 5.34. For 7 volts, voltage is 0.76, current is 6.37. For 8 volts, current is 7.36. So I have to increase like that up to 10 volts. Okay, from this table we have to draw the input characteristics and graph. For output characteristics, we don't require VBE voltage, so only we require only IE, IC and VCB, and remaining connection will be same I have connected here. Okay, well, this is IE purpose and this is IC purpose and this is VCB purpose. This multimeter is for VCB and this multimeter is for IC and this multimeter is for IE. I am doing the, let's do the experiment. Start the DRPS supply. Next, for output characteristics, we have to constant the IE value by varying the VEE. By using channel 1, we have to increase VEE value and constant some milliamps. IE value for 2 milliamps. And first, I am constanting the IE 2 milliamps by varying the VEE. So, I am increasing this one. Constant the IE value for input side, and for output side we have to increase VCB for like one stepwise 1 volts, 2 volts like that. By using VCC we have to increase VCC 1 volt, 2 volts like that, and we have to measure IC and VCB for the output characteristic graph purpose. Okay, for 0 volts we are getting current is 0.7 milliamps and voltage is minus 0.72. For 0 VCC volts, we are getting minus 0.72 volts VCB and current is 0.7 milliamps. Next, for 1 volt VCC, for 1 volt VCC, VCB is minus 0.67 and IC is 1.61 milliamps. For 2 volts VCC, voltage VCB is minus 0.1 volts and current is 2.1 milliamps. For 3 volts VCC, voltage VCB is 0.93 volts and current is 2.1. For 4 volts, okay. For 4 volts, VCB is 1.96 volts, current is 2.1 milliamps. For 5 volts, 2.97 VCB and current is 2.1. For 6 also, for 6 volts, voltage is 3.86 6 volts. For 6 volts VCC, we are getting 3.98 volts and current is 2.1. We are getting constant current here. IC is getting constant. For output, we required only output is constant current only. So we have got already 2.1 is constant current IC, And what we have supplied IE, you are getting output also IC same. So IE equal to approximately IC, that's why. For VCC 7 volts, VCB equal to 5.04 and current is 2.1. For 8 volts, VCC 8 volts, you are getting 6.05 VCB, current is 2.1. So already you got constant current, so it will enough for output characteristics values. For next, go to the minimize the VCC value 0, minimize 0. Next, you have to increase, next to IE will be 5 milliamps. You have to increase 2 milliamps to 5 milliamps. For 5 milliamps, you have to do the another graph purpose. I am constanting the IE is 5 milliamps. For IE 5 milliamps, we have to measure the values of VCB and IC. Same, repeat the procedure for what you have done for IE 2 milliamps. Okay. For VCB equal to 0 volts, you got VCB equal to VCC equal to 0 volts, you got minus 0.76 volts. For IC, IC is 0.74 milliamps. Increase stepwise 111 volt. Okay. Next, increase 1 volt for VCC. For 1 volt, for 1 volt VCC, you got VCC is minus 0.75 and IC is 1.7 milliamps. For 2 volts VCC, for 2 volts VCC, minus 0.74 and IC is 2.73. For 3 volts, for 3 volts VCC, VCB is minus 0.71 and current is 3.69. For 4 volts VCC, voltage is 0.67 and current is 4.59. For 5 volts VCC, minus 0.07 and current is 5.09. For 6 volts VCC, for 6 volts VCC, you are getting VCB is positive value, that is 0.94 positive and current is 5.09. For 7 volts VCC, for 7 volt VCC, 1.96 VCB, 5.09 IC. For 8 volts VCC, 3.05 VCB, 5.09 IC. So now we are getting constant current, that is IC. Okay. For 9 volts VCC, we are getting 4.06 VCB and 5.09 IC. For 10 volts VCC, we are getting 5.07 VCB, 5.09, current is constant we are getting here. For 11 volts VCC, 6.10 VCB, current is 5.1. So here we are getting, conclusion is IE equal to, already you know, IE equal to approximately IC. So we are getting IE constant is fixed to the values IE is 2 milliamp. We are getting approximately 2 milliamps current IC. Here also IE equal to 5 milliamps fixed. So you are getting, I am getting 5 milliamps, approximately 5 milliamps constant. From the graph, you have to calculate output resistance or not. That is delta VCB by delta VCB by delta IC, output voltage by output current. From this table, we have drawn the graph. So for VCB equal to 0 volts, and this is for VCB equal to 2 volts. VCB equal to 0 volts here, this graph will be VCB equal to 0, and this was for VCB equal to 2 volts. Okay, so if you increase the VCB voltage, VCB equal to 0, VCB equal to 2, VCB 3, it will come to left side. Okay, graph will be come to left side. Why? Because in the circuit diagram, base emitter junction is forward bias and collector base junction is reverse bias. For VCB equal to 0 volts, VCB equal to 0 volts, it acts as short circuit and it is same as normal PN junction diode, base to emitter junction. So your graph will be like this, you are getting here. If you increase the VCB voltage from 0 volts to 2 volts, so reverse voltage will be increases. So reverse bias also increases from collector to base junction. So width of the base junction will be decreases. So if you are increasing the VBE voltage, a current will be comes early. So that's why you are getting VCB equal to 0 volts for this graph and VCB equal to 2 volts for this graph. So your VCB increases, graph will be comes to left side only. If the VCB equal to 5 volts, if you draw the graph, you will get graph will be like this. So main reason is why it is coming left side means main effect is collector base junction will be in reverse bias. Okay, that's why current comes early in the reverse bias circuit. From this input characteristic graph, input characteristics graph, you have to calculate the input resistance RI. RI equal to delta VBE by delta IE. So you have to, from this graph, you have to locate one point here and point here and draw the line on x-axis and y-axis. I'm drawing here this one and this one is here. So this voltage will be delta VBE, and from this graph you have to draw a straight line from to y axis. Point will be here, so from here to y axis graph. So this total width will be from here to here. This is delta I. So you can calculate this value 0.7 something, 0.78 to minus, this is 0.72 by delta I. Delta I means here 2 volts, 2 milliamps, here 2.5, so it is 2.5, so 2.3. Minus here 6.6 minus 2.3. So you will get RI, input resistance. Okay. From the output characteristics, you have to calculate R out, that is delta VCE by delta IC. From this table, we have drawn the graph of output characteristics of common base characteristics. Here x-axis, here and x-axis, this is y-axis. In the x-axis we have taken VCB in volts and the y-axis we have taken IC in milliamps. Here one unit equal to 1 centimeter equal to 1 volt for in x-axis. In y-axis 1 centimeter equal to, or 1 unit equal to 0.5 milliamps. Here this portion up to 0, we are getting this portion will be there. This is saturation region. From here to here, this is saturation region. This portion is saturation region. Now this portion is active region. here you got constant current, here also you got constant current. For IE equal to 2 milliamps, IE equal to 5 milliamps. Okay. Thank you.